steps.
Thank you.
Today's scripture is Matthew 5, verses 13 through 20. You are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on the hill cannot be hidden. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth passes away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter, will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you, unless your righteousness exceeds that of the scribes and the Pharisees, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. May God grant us understanding to his word.
Gracious God, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, our strength, and our redeemer. You remember last week I talked about the difference between gospel and law. Gospel being that which Jesus taught, that which Jesus did in his whole ministry, that's a gospel. Law then being what we're supposed to do because we've heard the gospel. Okay, so it's not so much the whole law about you can only drive so fast on that road or you have to come to a complete stop, the stop sign. We're talking about a different kind of law here. Biblical law, gospel law, is doing as Jesus taught us to do. Doing, following exactly through his ministry. And, you know, this text is actually perfect, I think, for where we're at in our world right now. There's a lot of angst all around us. There's a lot of division. There's a lot of crime. There's a lot of illness. There's a lot of poverty. We need to be reminded what Jesus asks of us in the midst of all this chaos, in the midst of all this angst. All those things that we'd rather trample underfoot because they just cause destruction, right? Those kind of things. I just don't want to do that. I'm just going to trample it underfoot and walk away. Okay? That's a good thing to do with all those negative realities of our world. But Jesus asks something pretty strong of us. You are salt for the earth. You are salt for the earth. And if we remember the three examples we had with the kids, we've got table salt that makes food taste better. We've got sidewalk salt that keeps us safe from falling on all that ice. And we've got this water softener salt that makes things pure and it takes the bad stuff out, right? So you are salt for the earth. When you think about it in those terms, you are salt for the earth. You have the power to do good. That's what Jesus is saying to us. In the midst of all this anxiety and all this angst, you have the power to do good. It's powerful, very powerful. You know, we learn in kindergarten, if you don't have anything nice to say, then don't say anything at all, right? We need to be reminded of that even when we're out of kindergarten. Because as these things happen in the world, we get kind of, worked up, right? And it's so easy to just throw insults out there. Let's just call each other ignorant. Let's just call each other whiny. Let's just say that they just don't get it and they just don't understand. What does that do when we do that? What does it do? Does it help at all? Shake your heads, no. It doesn't help at all. What it does is divides us even more. And we here at CPC, we like to think that we got it right, right? Like, we're welcoming and we let everybody come in, but we mess up. We mess up. I mess up. I get into it sometimes and I'm like, oh, I don't understand how anybody that doesn't get this, why I don't get it? And as soon as I do that, as soon as I draw that line and say, I'm here and you're there and there's no way we can get together on this, I draw a line in being salt of the earth. I draw a line in anything being good and right out of that situation. That's what Jesus is calling us to do. We have to stop all those things that are dividing us and wanting to be trampled underfoot. We have to stop that and do good for for the earth, do good for the world, do good for our fellow humanity. Do good by following the gospel of Jesus Christ. And this is actually an amazing text because there's this really powerful line in it. Gospel law still exists. The law will exist, Jesus says. I'm not going to take it away. Now remember what law is. Doing what we've been taught, right? I'm not going to take it away, Jesus said. That gospel is still going to exist until all is accomplished. Until all is accomplished. What does that mean? It means until my gospel is reality. It's going to stand. It's going to be here. It's going to be driven into the word and into what I'm calling you to do as people until it becomes a reality. So until the gospel of Christ, all that Christ did and all the love Christ shared, until that becomes our reality, it's going to be there in front of us. It's going to be our challenge. It's going to be our call. So let us today and let us this week truly stop and think about the things we're saying and the things we're doing. And let's ask ourselves, is that bringing good to this situation? Or is that really just pushing more into the pile of things we want to trample?